In today's video, I want to talk about the importance of occasionally working in a style that isn't to your taste as an artist, and why it can indirectly help you find your own style. Hi everyone, Malachi James here. If you've just discovered me, and you're an aspiring artist and you want to hear more art, animation and industry related discussions, make sure you subscribe and click the bell so you're always up to date. Okay, so, a little while ago, I learned something about my creative taste that I hadn't thought about as deeply before. I learned that I don't need to publicly explore as much variety in my art as I thought. After consuming such a variety of artistic styles on social media, such as realism, fantasy concept art, science fiction, expressionism, etc., I used to find myself feeling as though I needed to prove that I could achieve these styles to publicly show off how technically capable I might think I am, even though I already know that I am only truly interested in exploring the variety that cartooning has to offer. And I suspect that my audience knows this about me as well. May I kindly ask that you stop whatever you're doing for a moment and just take a look at this digital painting I'm doing in this part of the video. Now, I wouldn't go as far as to say that I hated painting this semi-realistic portrait, but at the time I decided to paint it, I might have felt pressure to prove that I could paint like this after seeing lots of successful realistic painters on Instagram. And perhaps to the average Joe, I also felt the need to debunk the myth that cartoonists are incapable of drawing and painting realistically. And come to think of it, I was probably trying to prove to myself that I hadn't lost my academic skills. I actually painted this a little while before I even started taking this YouTube channel seriously, and I guess, in more ways than one, this painting was something I created out of insecurity. And with that said, had I not had that revelation, I wouldn't have discovered so clearly that I don't need to create work that looks like the work of other artists. In fact, the realization that I want to pursue cartooning above all else had never been clearer in my life after painting this. Now, if you have a little look at the drawing I'm working on in this part of the video, you might be able to recognize that this style is something much more relevant to the direction I'm going in. So, after reassuring myself that pursuing the endless possibilities of cartooning itself, I realize that there is potential for me to discover places that no other cartoonist has ever gone before. In terms of inspiration for my lifelong cartooning process, I know that the style I want to pursue is rooted in the work of character designer Ed Benedict from the mid-century Hanna-Barbera era. It's his minimalism and clarity that really came to be the staple of TV cartoon animation. But by the 70s and 80s came the fall of the TV cartoon, where the design became the opposite of my taste, semi-realistic animation. And out of the ashes, a new generation of cartoonists in the 90s rekindled that clarity of design pioneered by Ed Benedict. And I would say, I'm certainly more influenced by the 90s cartoonists like Lynn Naylor, Bruce Timm, Genndy Tartakovsky, Bob Camp, and Danny Antonucci. This talented bunch all paid tribute to that brilliant mid-century cartoon style. And I want to do the same, just in a more 21st century way. And I'm also influenced by some contemporary designers like Jackie Draco and Anna Katish. But my heart definitely lies in pushing the 90s cartoonist styles further and seeing what new things I can create with that approach. So, thank goodness I did that semi-realistic painting. because it did in fact help me get one step closer to my goals. I'm now even more adamant that I go down in that cartoony direction in my art and animation. And if you ever consider making art that is very popular but isn't to your taste, go for it. Because remember, it can reaffirm your true artistic ambitions in ways you never thought were possible. I've left links in the description below to see finished versions of both my semi-realistic painting and my cartoony drawing. Let me know your thoughts about this topic in the comment section below. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and share with fellow artists. Stay positive, everyone. Keep creating, and I'll see you all in the next video. Bye-bye.